The education minister seeking to quell serious concerns expressed by the opposition leader, and that's that the 2020-2021 budget does not reflect a post-COVID response.
We know that a number of persons with students in private schools may not be able to continue to keep them in private schools. That's going to require a pressure on the public. I don't see any response to that possibility in the budget. For example, increase in subventions to private schools, whether or not you're negotiating with the private schools to see how you can alleviate or, as it were, prevent such pressure coming on them. I know also if school starts again, it may also require, if you have social distancing, it then means that where you have a classroom of 30, you may now only have a classroom of, what, 12, maybe, or 15.
An increase of some $350,000 has been set aside to assist private schools in the upcoming fiscal year. While noting that this may not seem like much, Minister Jeffrey Lloyd said a lot of private schools have already indicated plans to have much of their instruction time virtual. As indicated during his budget contribution last week, a rotational system is being considered for the public school system.
Another consideration that is very important for us, Mr. Speaker, is a number of the islands, certainly Grand Bahama and Abaco, as well as a few of the southern islands, would have lost precious days, school days. We have only 190 school days per year, and all of them are absolutely positively needed. We would like to certainly have more. The decision now, some consideration is being given as to whether schools will start a week earlier than usual, somewhere around the last week of August, as an example. We are working closely with some of our partners, Alive and BTC and other vendors, in the expansion of the broadband, which they already have done. The government is looking very closely at the possible consideration of providing, along with our partners, we are looking at how we can make all of the schools right now smart schools.
This way, says Lloyd, children can go on campuses, complete schoolwork, while maintaining social distancing.